Of the seminar is actually, there's a lot of people who have a lot of questions about Chinese social media. A lot of people have been going to restaurants and stores and seeing the WeChat Pay and Alipay logo at a lot of cashiers. And so there's been a number of questions. First of all, what is WeChat Pay and what is Alipay? And how can they get on it? And I wanted to work with some partners in my industry to basically figure out and help them break down exactly what WeChat Pay is, what Alipay is, and how that ties into the social media aspect. Because a lot of people use WeChat. They have no idea about the payment side, and they have no idea even how the whole thing works. So really, we're here today to talk about everything. Also, if you advertise through Facebook, Google, and whatnot, there's a lot of data. There isn't a lot of data currently published about WeChat, and certainly not data in the Canadian context. If you look at the overall data that Tencent publishes, it's about either global statistics or stats in China. What we wanted to do was help Canadian marketers and ad agencies understand how it would help them to advertise in Canada using WeChat as a social media platform.
People may ask, is WeChat really important in Canada or in Chinese community? What do you say?
Well, that's what they're going to hear about today. But in a very short nutshell, it is important if you have a Chinese clientele from China. But a lot of people in Canada, especially marketers, they don't even understand the difference between Chinese and Chinese from China. The average Chinese person who's lived in Canada for a long time will never use WeChat Pay. The average Chinese person in Canada, even from China, who came here 5-10 years ago, is not even eligible to have a WeChat Pay wallet. So that's what I'm here to explain today, as to who is eligible, who would actually be your customer, and those that actually have a wallet that is charged with money.
So you want to build a bridge like between Chinese community and other companies to understand each other?
What we want to do out of today is, first of all, we want everybody here in the audience to leave with more information and also to consider using WeChat and the whole ecosystem of WeChat as a social media platform and WeChat Pay and Alipay as part of their overall marketing strategy. Not just as one piece, but as part of their overall marketing strategy.
Not a lot of people.
So we talk about data security, data integrity.
We will talk a lot about that, and quite honestly, and this is negative to say, but the moment I talk about payment systems and China, people think, especially Canadians, they say, oh, there's a lot of scams. And, you know, because there are a lot of scams, unfortunately, that are perpetrated out of countries like China and Russia and the former Soviet states. And I will talk a bit about the scams that are out there and who they generally affect. But they do not affect, most of the scams do not affect merchants themselves, the actual companies that are accepting WeChat payments.
Yeah. So how do you think the trends in the future?
For WeChat Pay and Alipay in Canada?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would say that there is a window of opportunity. To make it very, very sort of a very short conclusion to this, right now the advantage of using for a store or a business to accept WeChat Pay or Alipay, you are accepting renminbi. Okay, for immigrants from China, they want to spend their renminbi because either they couldn't get it out of China or they've already reached their maximum. That amount of renminbi, if they're immigrating to Canada, is going to get less and less over time, and the Canadian dollar amount is going to go up, meaning they will over time use WeChat Pay less and less and less in Canada. But in the short term, yes, there's definitely a need.